One, two, three.
I'm Microsoft teaming with Microsoft Teams. I'm learning and dreaming with Microsoft Teams. The hub and the teamwork of Microsoft 365 in these quarantine times. I'm Microsoft teaming with Microsoft Teams. Yeah, with Microsoft Teams.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to this special bonus episode of Inside Microsoft Teams. I'm your host, Stephen Rose. Thanks for joining. In episode one this season, we did a segment with Atlassian on the new Jira integration for IT pros, and we got a ton of great feedback, but none louder than devs who said, yeah, IT pro, that's great, but as Pink says, what about us? So, hey, we're here to fix that with a special episode dedicated to Jira for developers. Before we begin, I want you to share your favorite feature you're seeing today on Twitter with the hashtag Jira for Teams by March 10th. All you need to do is tweet your favorite feature of the new Jira app. We're going to talk about it today with that hashtag on the show. On March 10th, we'll pick three winners, and you will get $50 to spend at the Atlassian Swag Store, where they have cool shirts like this. So make sure to check it out. To set the table, Atlassian's Jira, Confluence, Trello, and Atlassian Assist, that used to be known as Help, integrations for IT pros and devs with Microsoft Teams makes project management and issues trackable, viewable across common Teams functions like chats and channels and directly within meetings. And what's great is this is not a plugin for Teams. They have integrated this into the platform. Why the Teams integration makes the difference? Because it's about where the majority of your work and your conversations happen. So let's get started. I'm happy to welcome back Tiger to the show. Hi, Tiger. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thank you so much for having me back. I'm very excited to be here.
I'm glad you're excited and you're well rested. Just came back from vacation. You're ready to knock it out. So for those who sadly might have missed our first episode, introduce yourself, tell them who you are, and let's jump into our first segment.
Absolutely. I'm Tiger Dos Domingos. I am the product manager for the Jira Cloud for Microsoft Teams app. And I'm super excited to share with y'all today a little bit about the life of a developer using our app. We'll give you a few little tips and tricks as well, and then also what's coming next. Before I dive in, I just want to remind y'all that the Jira Cloud integration with Teams can be used with any of our subscription licenses, including the free option, which allows up to 10 users. So if you're on standard or premium, go ahead and add that on there. I know, it's a lot, right?
It's awesome. So one of my closest friends, Daniel Egan, he is a dev. He starts his day with a Mountain Dew and then plays his Music for Devs playlist. And as I like to say, begins his day looking for needles in haystacks. So how can we make that easier and reduce that mountain of clicks into a manageable molehill?
All right, let's take a look. I start my day with some coffee, perhaps a little Java. Sorry, I really had to do that joke. And so I hate email because it takes me out of Teams and I have to context switch every time for updates. But thanks to this new app, I can jump straight into Teams, to the bot, and see my Jira notifications here. I can see Tony finished this ticket. It's done. I want to leave a little comment letting him know I saw the ticket. What a great job he did. So here we go. And post, done. Now, after catching up on my Jira notifications, I can view issues assigned to me in my personal tab. So I'm gonna go up to the top here and I'm gonna choose my filter. So what you start with is gonna be your cloud site. If you have several like me, you're gonna choose one of them. You're also gonna choose the assigned to me filter. There are others that you can choose from here, but that's the one I wanna look at for today. The last part is my status. I'm going to look for what's in progress and bam. So the cool part here is also I can toggle any of these fields so I can see exactly what I want in a specific order. For today, I'm going to check priority. So I want to see what's the highest priority on my list. I got a couple right here I can start my day off with and I'm good to go. So then I go over to my team chat and I see a little bit of a ping from my PM. And she has attached a Jira ticket link and it's got a rich preview. I can see the title, which project it belongs to, the priority. And there's also a ton of additional valuable context when I click on the view details. So I can also go down and comment, edit, or open this in actual Jira. Now, I can also see she left a note that this needs to get done and sent over to Griffin. So I'm going to go ahead and add that message to the ticket so it's not getting lost in any conversation. So I'm going to choose the issue there, post that comment. Excellent. I also want to use the handy search function. So I just finished a ticket. I want to search for it. There it is. Bam. And I'm going to let other teammates know, hey, just finished this. Can I get some eyes on the UI over here? I can send that and voila. So a quick reminder, you can use that search functionality in the group or team channel chats also. We will also now switch gears a little bit. So it's time for our daily stand-up. So I'm going to navigate over to that meeting. I'm going to join. We're going to turn our camera off. And we've got the meeting started. Now you will see the Jira icon in that top bar over there. When you open that up, it's great. I can see all of the issues that I have worked on, viewed, have been assigned to. So I can choose any of these to share in this meeting. It's great. I can comment on it. I can look for additional description about the issue that I'm sharing. Everyone in the meeting can see this. So we're collaborating in real time and talking about this. As you can see, I can also edit this, add a comment, and go from there. So those are kind of the highlighted features that a lot of our devs use. While I'm focused on the developers during this session, we've seen many customers use the Jira app to track ITSM requests as well. So if you're leveraging that awesome integration with Jira software and Jira Service Management, you can connect both projects in here and action them as needed. And while technical teams are typically early adopters of Jira, it's really important to note that it is flexible enough to be used to track work across diverse business functions. You can have marketing, all the way to finance and operations. We have different boards, different projects for exactly those needs. So take a look at that. And in fact, one of the key benefits of the Jira app and Teams is you'll have stakeholders that don't have to navigate to Jira or create or update an issue. And even in one of my customer interviews, they let me know that the biggest benefit for them installing the Jira apps in Microsoft Teams was how easy it was to get everyone on board with updating their tickets.
That was great. And you did all that without ever leaving Teams. So what about those millions of folks who are already Jira users? What are some of your favorite tips and tricks that make those everyday tasks just that much easier?
Yep. Let me take you for a look in here. So for our Teams admins out there, I just want to touch on some best practices for rolling out the app for users. I'm sure some of you are asking, what can be managed through Jira versus the Team Admin Center, right? So you'll need to go into your Jira admin settings in the browser to set up permissions for content there. But you can allow third-party apps and Microsoft Teams through their admin center separately. And what's unique to Teams is you really have a lot more granularity and control on this. In Slack, you know, you might have just a communication tool, but with Microsoft Teams, you're really talking about a much more comprehensive platform. So here's some basic admin steps to just kind of go through. First thing I want to do, you're going to go to your team apps. You're going to click on permission policies, and you have one under here for global. So the ones we're looking for are third-party apps, which is where Jira resides. You can allow all apps that are third-party, or if you're feeling a little bit more security conscious, you can just allow specific ones. So if you do that, all you have to do is search for Jira in here. It's the cloud version. You're going to add that, and bam, you're good to go. The other option you have also is to go to your Manage Apps tab over there. You can also search in here, and then bam, open that up. Make sure it's allowed. The other option you have here also is to just review all the permissions, and this really takes out a chunk of work for all of the people in your organization when they're adding this. Once you've reviewed this, you said it's okay, you don't have to go back and forth with those users sending you emails saying, hey, let me in. So I highly recommend reviewing the permissions, okaying them here. And if you have a lot of Jira users, you can just go ahead and pin it also in the tab on the left here. So once all that's done, you can search for this app. I'm going to add it to a team here. So let's see, I'm going to do sales and marketing. I'm going to set this up. And what happens here is I'm able to choose a tab to pin my Jira backlog onto. So choose a filter in here. This is great for transparency with your entire team, so everyone can see exactly what work's happening, what's done, what's not, what's in progress. It's cool. You can create new issues in here. You can also just click on an issue to edit it. So once you're in here, you can add more description. You can add fields. We have custom fields now. If you want to add an attachment, you can go ahead and do that and then save it. And so what's cool is also, like I was saying, you have other groups of users that are going to have Jira on your team. So I'm going to go to my retail space here. I've shared a link in there. We're connecting cross-collaboration teams together in this. They can see all the same rich context in here. And at the top, you're going to see what's a what we call a welcome card. So we have these in all the different scopes, and it just makes you aware of what features you're getting from the app. So for this one, you know, you get the link previews. You're able to search for Jira issues in that messaging extension. You can pin a tab. You're able to update issues. You can edit them, comment. If there's messages you want to add to a new issue, you can do that. If there's messages you want to add to an existing one, you can also. It also tells you about the other features that are in this, like personal notifications or the meetings part that I showed y'all earlier. And what we recommend is adding specifically this app to your personal bot or to the meeting. You do need to add it manually, but that will really help you unlock all the total features within this app. So I'm also going to go back to the bot over here. If you need more information about what this does, you can go to the About section over here. You can also go ahead and if you have any trouble signing in and stuff, please log in through the web browser for Teams just in case. But we also really, really want to hear from you. So anytime, please just type in feedback to the bot. If you're having trouble signing in, let us know. If you want a feature request, let us know. I personally read every single one of these. So we are listening and we are paying attention.
Thanks, Tiger. I love seeing the deep integration into the Teams Admin Center. So what's next? What can Jira users look forward to in the next few months?
So our team is definitely continuing to look at customer feedback, doing customer interviews, and building as much value as we can within this integration. And it's not just Jira that we're investing in on with the Teams platform. We have a Confluence for Teams app that is shipping some exciting new features next month that'll bring a lot of the richness of the Confluence Cloud Editor experience into Teams. Also, Atlassian is bringing several new Teams integrations to market, so please stay tuned for that.
Great stuff from Tiger and from Atlassian. I want to thank them so much for being on the show. Tiger, thanks for taking out time. I know you're just back from vacation, so it was really great of you to take some time and go through all this with us today.
Thank you so much for having me. It's always fun here.
All right. So ability to get everything in one place, deep integration into the Teams platform, providing great team agility. It's all right there. So go to the App Store if you have Jira and install the add-ins for Jira right there into Teams. If you're not, you can go out to the Jira website. You can get 10 users for free and start to use it today, which is great. And hey, don't forget about our swag promo. If you use the hashtag Jira for Teams and share your favorite part of this show, oh, by March 10th, they're going to pick three winners for $50 in swag, and you get yourself a cool shirt like this or some other shirt that you think is cool. We also have several blogs coming out today. We have one from our GM coming out that will talk about the great partnership and what we're doing here on our Teams blog. We have our tech community blog, which is the link right below my face inside MS Teams, Jira for Teams. So you can check that out and learn more. And of course, all the great stuff here on our show, which we want to have you encourage and check out our previous show where we dig into the IT Pro Readiness piece. So, blogs to check out, swag to potentially win, plugins inside of our app store to drop in, deep integration, free use. I don't think did I miss anything, Tiger?
That's all of it, I think.
I think that's all of it. So with that, have a great day. We will see you for episode 2 in the next few weeks on Inside Microsoft Teams. I'm your host, Stephen Rose, and thank you for taking some time out today to join us. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.